My wife and I have been traveling giving chastity presentations internationally for the past more than a dozen years or so. And after the presentations, we'll often tell the students, hey, if you guys need to hang out and talk one-on-one, we'll be here for you. And sometimes the students will form lines hours and hours long. I remember one school where the students formed a line 7 hours long, and we were there till 5:30 at night going through their questions. And the college students and the high school students, many of the young women would ask the same things of just like, how do I know if a guy really loves me or if he's just saying it? How do I know when I'm ready to date? Am I being too picky? How do I know which standards to stick to? And are there any decent guys out there anymore? And how do I heal? And how do I know this and that? And we started to hear so many of the same struggles that these single women were going through. And I would correspond with them through email. And then when I would write these responses to the girls, I would start saving them and say, you know, I need to just share this with other girls. And over the years, this started to compile into somewhat of a compendium of answers to the young women's most common questions on how to navigate through the single years of life while keeping your dignity and morals and faith intact. And so eventually it started to evolve into a book. And then I started to have this dream and this vision of just creating one manual that you could give to any single woman, whether she's 16 or 17 years old or a single professional at the age of 34 living out in the world, that you could hand to them and say, hey, just this is going to help get you through these tough years, to know which guys to avoid, to know that you don't need to give up hope, that you don't have to lower your morals to find love, because if you do, then it's not love that you're finding. And so for several years, been working on this, putting it together, and thankfully my wife worked with me on doing it to provide a female perspective of what it's like to have to struggle through these difficult years of life, where you sometimes give up hope that love is even out there. And so that's kind of the story where the book came from, and I'm just beyond excited that it finally showed up today on Valentine's Day of all days from the printer. So,
hey, yeah, that's a good coincidence to have. Yeah. Now, when the boxes were brought into the warehouse, I'm sure somebody said, hey, you better come down, your book's here, and to be able to break it out of the carton. How would you describe the book, Jason, in terms of obviously some people might be a little scared if a book is too big or too ponderous, and I know all of your books have been very accessible. What can you tell our listeners about the new book, which is again called How to Find Your Soulmate Without Losing Your Soul, such that they would have an idea of, maybe they might even be thinking about someone to give it to? What can you tell them about that, the presentation?
Well, it's very non-threatening because the chapters, we've got 21 different chapters. The subtitle is 21 Secrets for Women, and they're just 21 different tips that a young woman can use and employ within these dating years to help find the love that's written on their hearts. Because a lot of girls have this vision of love, but maybe they've never even seen it. Maybe they come from a broken family and they wonder, you know, am I just a freak of nature? Because I just want this godly, beautiful, undivided, completely faithful love. Because I don't see it. My friends don't have it. My family never had it, but I want it. And so these short chapters are able to appeal to the desires of their heart. And I think that young people today are some of the best apostles to bring the message of chastity to their friends. And so what we decided to do with this book is the hardcover is what just came out today. And that's a nice hardcover Barnes & Noble looking book. And we're also going to be coming out within about a month and a half from now, a softcover edition of it, which is going to be for sale at $2 a piece, but you have to buy them a case at a time. So if you're a youth minister or you work at a dorm and campus ministry or high school religion, you can spend $80 and get 40 books and then use that to evangelize the students in your area and the young people. And today, the radio offers, if you get the book today, we're going to include a CD of my wife's testimony that just came out about a week ago. And this is part of a series we're starting called the Chastity Project, where if you buy one CD, you get unlimited rights to burn as many of these things as you want. And anyone who hears it has unlimited rights to burn their CD as well. And so we've done this to create a whole line of CDs, and hers is the first one in it. But these teens will get these testimonies of my wife's conversion story and hear it. Oh, I've got three friends at work who need this. I've got two girls at the dorm who really need this. And then they can just burn them and share them. And so between the book and the CD, I think we're going to be able to reach, God willing, quite a few souls.